Now this is the experimental setup for a twin cylinder 4-stroke diesel engine, or you can say this is the test rig having a Kirloskar twin cylinder diesel engine. So this is one cylinder, this is another cylinder, this is representing. This setup doesn't have any self start facility, so we need to crank the engine, and by using this handle we need to crank, and before that we need to open the decompressor lever, and we have to rotate this knob, and after getting the sufficient speed we need to close this knob so that the compression is developed and the engine automatically starts. And the care to be taken is, before actually starting the experiment, we need to set the flow rate by using this flow meter, and it is connected to the water supply line, and the coolant water will be supplied to the engine, and we need to set this as per the specification. And here the engine is connected to a dynamometer, and the dynamometer is nothing but, here it is an eddy current type of dynamometer. So the loading will be electrical loading, and eddy current dynamometer output is being communicated with the various coils. So here, for loading the engine, we need to switch on these coils one by one in sequence. And for switching on this load, here we have the arrangement. So the each indicator represents one heater coil, and here we have the buttons for bringing each of this heater coil into the circuit. So first the engine will be started, and it is operated without load or without switching on any of these coils. So five coils, heater coils, and five switches are there, and in sequence one by one we can switch on for getting the experimental results. So initially, no load condition, the engine is started and the fuel is available. This is the fuel tank, and the fuel, from the fuel tank, with this three-way valve, we can get the fuel into this particular device or the burette, and from this burette the fuel will be supplied to the injectors, and we can control the flow of the fuel by using this lever. Okay, so here you can observe, it is a temperature indicator, and temperature of various parameters of the engine. For example, T1, water inlet temperature to calorimeter. So this is useful for drawing the heat balance sheet and to know the what is the heat taken by the exhaust gases. For that purpose, calorimeter water is to be, temperature is noted. T2 is the water outlet temperature from the calorimeter, means calorimeter inlet temperature, calorimeter water outlet temperature. Similarly, exhaust gas outlet temperature and exhaust gas inlet temperature to the calorimeter, and exhaust gas outlet temperature from the calorimeter, water inlet temperature to the engine, water outlet temperature from the engine, and the room temperature. So 8 temperatures can be obtained by using this knob, and you can see now this is 32 degree, it is representing 32, means 32 degrees Celsius, and it is the current room temperature. So by turning this knob, we can get required T1, T2, T3, T4 up to T8. For each experiment, we need to note down all these temperature values so that we can calculate the efficiency parameters as well as heat balance sheet. And we can see that this is a air box. The atmospheric air is taken into the engine via this box, and that air flow can be measured with the help of the manometer that is communicating with the air box. The air box has a orifice, and the orifice diameter already we have discussed there. And here you can see the left wing of the manometer. It is U-tube manometer having left and right limbs, and the left limb is connected to the air box, and right limb is open to the atmosphere. So the differential pressure can be identified by the level of the water in the left and the right limbs of this U-tube manometer. Now the engine is not started, so the reading at the left and the right will be remaining same, Once the engine is started, there will be difference in pressure between the atmosphere and the engine, and the limbs, the height will be varying, and that difference is to be noted for calculating the air consumed by the engine. And you can see here, this is the device, the electrical generator. You can say eddy current generator, which is communicating with the engine. The flywheel is communicating with the input shaft of this generator, and as soon as the engine starts, the generator starts working. And in no load condition, if no coil is switched on, there will be no load on the engine. And once a coil is switched on, due to the principle of eddy current, the engine will be loaded. And when the engine is loaded, the fuel consumption parameters will vary. Here, the time taken for 10 cc of fuel consumption is noted down in each experiment. And similarly, the left and right limb differences will be noted, and it is used for the calculations. So initially, one coil is switched on, all temperatures are noted down, 10 cc fuel consumption time is noted down, and this limb difference is also noted down. Next, second coil is switched on, and all readings are taken once again, once the engine is stabilized. Again, similarly, the procedure is repeated with the third coil, fourth coil, and fifth coil. Now the engine is in full load condition. We are allowing the engine to settle down at a stable condition. Then we are noting down all temperatures T1 to T8, and at the same time we are noting down the difference of this left and the right limbs of this manometer. And at the same time, for each reading, we are calculating or noting down the time taken for 10 cc fuel consumption. So the care should be taken while operating the engine. That is, the first thing is we need to confirm the water supply to the engine, because without the water supply, if we start the engine, it may lead to the seizure of the piston, and which is not allowed. And at the same time, one should be careful while starting the engine by the cranking, and before cranking we need to open the decompressor lever, otherwise because of high compression ratio we cannot crank the engine. We need to open at least one of this decompressor lever. We need to crank, and then once the speed is available, we need to shut down the lever so that the engine will start. And one should be very careful while disengaging the lever, otherwise it may harm the user, and it should be very careful. So that is about the procedure of experimental procedure for the load test on this particular twin cylinder, four stroke, Kirloskar diesel engine, where we can calculate from this experiment both the heat balance sheet parameters as well as the performance parameters, what already we have discussed. Okay, thank you.